Hey there. All right. So, topic of conversation that has come up a lot lately. Hopefully, by you're listening to this episode mid-September somewhere, depending on when you're catching it. But this really is relevant any time of the year, but specifically right now with where things are happening. So, it's September 2021 when I'm recording this episode. And the general feeling right now, across a lot of entrepreneurs, is this feeling of overwhelm, right? This feeling of just being stuck, not really having a direction or a great focus on what to do or what's ahead, just because I think there's just a lot of factors outside of our control right now. And that's a topic for another day. But my point is this, is that if you are feeling overwhelmed, okay, you're coming into the last 4 months of the year, September through December. And again, if you're listening to this at any other given point, think about it from a quarterly perspective. If you find yourself getting stuck, if you find yourself getting overwhelmed, here's what I want you to do. I want you to really focus on one thing and one thing only for the remainder of the year, or the remainder of the quarter, whatever that may be. And what I mean by that is, like, pick one topic. 90% of us have multiple different things we could talk about. We have multiple different offers that we can promote. We have multiple different passions inside of our business. But I want you, if you're feeling kind of in this state of overwhelm and just shut down and not really knowing what direction to take, I want you to pick one thing. So I'm going to give you an example of a conversation that I had. I was talking with an accountant who was kind of feeling all over because she could talk about like retainer type services for bookkeeping, or she could talk about taxes, or she could talk about really empowering other entrepreneurs to like understanding your numbers and all of this, and just feeling kind of shut down, feeling bored, feeling like her messaging wasn't being heard. And the thing about it is that we're on information overload. I think some of this overwhelm is coming from the fact that we feel like we're putting ourselves out there and it's not getting anywhere. And one of the things that you can do is, like I said, focus on one thing. So for her, it was, let's talk about taxes. You're coming into year end. Everybody's kind of getting into this tax season, tax mode. Like, should I be spending money towards the end of the year? Should I not? And so I was like, pick one offer, like pick a tax audit, say, hey, for entrepreneurs looking to, you know, have somebody take a look at their books. If you're not working with a CPA, can you, let's do a tax audit and let's talk about it and let's look at your books and we'll make sure that you're set up properly for the end of the year going into tax season where you're not going to owe the IRS all this money, et cetera. This is just one example I'm giving you. And so my point was to her is like, just promote that one service for the next four months. And the reality is it's not that, and the goal is that one service then may lead to either a tax client, that one service then may lead to a retainer bookkeeping type accounting client. It leads to something else. You're not trying to do everything. You're just focusing on one thing. And the reality is that because we are in information overload, by just repeating the same thing over and over, it allows your audience to see it, right? Because they might not see it the first time you talked about it. They might not see it in September, but they might be seeing it in October. Or in September, it might not necessarily be relevant for them, or it might not be the right timing, but maybe come October, you're still talking about it. Now it's like, oh yeah, now you've got testimonials, you've got new social proof. And so they build momentum on top of each other, right? Because like I said, now you've got social proof, you've got these testimonials, people are seeing you talk about the same thing, and you just never know when it's going to resonate. So it really helps you to take some of that overwhelm and pressure off yourself to know, like, okay, here's what I'm focused on. This is what I'm going to talk about. And I'm going to maintain my focus for the next 3 months on this versus trying to be all over the place. And you can get very specific with it, right? You can talk about all the different things that are relevant to tax season. Or I have another client who has a 10-day challenge. And instead of making a new challenge or working on a new lead magnet or creating a masterclass, Because again, the tech side of it is overwhelming. The timing of getting everything all done and figuring out the promotion, that can all get super overwhelming every time you're trying to do something new. So the point was, like, just launch your 10-day challenge again. Just because you launched it in August doesn't mean there's not people in September that might sign up for it. Because again, your audience is forever changing. You're constantly getting new clients or new audience people, like people that are following you, right? Like, you're gaining new visibility. If you're doing your job to increase your visibility every day to build your audience, then it doesn't matter that you're promoting the same thing, right? It doesn't matter, because what if somebody was on vacation during your 10-day challenge in August? It doesn't mean they're not interested. It means it wasn't the right time. So promote it again in September, promote it again in October, promote it again in November. And so you're only focusing on one thing. You don't need to create new tech. You don't need to create new social posts. You don't need to create a new landing page and all of that. It's all done. It takes the overwhelm away, and it allows you to capitalize on something you've already done. So you can do this in a variety of different ways. Go back through, look at a program you launched maybe 6 months ago. Pick it. If it was successful 6 months ago, do it again. You know, focus on one thing, solve one problem. That's a topic for another day, another podcast, which I'm going to record. But my point is that, like, reduce the overwhelm for yourself. Your audience doesn't need something new every time, okay? And again, like, we are skeptics. Think about your own buying habits. 90% of the time, you do not buy the first time you see something. But when somebody launches it again, you're like, oh, she's doing that again. I missed it that last time. And then she starts posting testimonials. You're like, oh, well, that's cool. I want those same results, right? Like, you have an audience of people that are watching you that are not, like, quick action takers. They need to see you doing something over and over. Like, that it builds credibility within themselves, or like somehow it makes it more legit for them. Like, again, it's not up for you to understand the psychology of people or to analyze people's decision-making, you know, powers. Like, that's, you drive yourself crazy trying to figure that out. Your job is to show up, and to show up confidently, and make sure that you're offering something that people need. And if you've done it once and people bought it or people signed up for it, then you have a validated offer. So keep doing it. Don't try to create something new. You don't need new. Focus on one thing and stick with it through the end of the year. Like I said, the goal can always be that there's a next step for the client, right? Like, this client that's launching this 10-day challenge, the goal is to get them into an 8-week program. But she's not promoting the 8-week program. She's promoting the 10-day challenge. And from the 10-day challenge, she promotes the 8-week program internally. But same thing, 10-day challenge, 8-week program, 10-day challenge, 8-week program. Both of them are already done. Both of them she can just continue to promote. They don't require new tech. It reduces overwhelm, and it allows your audience to see that you are continuing to stick with one thing, and you get known as the expert in that. You get known. It builds your credibility. Okay. So take that overwhelm away from yourself right now. Pick one thing. I want to know, like, what is that you can focus on from now until the end of the year? Is it one specific offer? Is it a specific lead magnet? Is it a specific challenge or masterclass? What is it that you can talk about that will totally reduce the stress and overwhelm from yourself? That's the goal, right? Just reduce that. Like, stop putting so much pressure on yourself. Just pick one thing. One thing, that's it. You don't need a million offers. I talk about that all the time, but really what I'm focusing on now is saying, like, if you are feeling overwhelmed, pick something that is easy for you to promote. It doesn't make you lazy. It not at all. And I know many of you are probably going to think that. It's not lazy at all. It's simplifying your business. It's honoring your body. It's honoring your mind. It's making it so that you can show up in the best way possible for your clients. Because if you're overwhelmed, you can't show up properly. So reduce that overwhelm and show up in the best way possible. Okay? Let me know what that one thing is. I want to know what you're focused on. I want to hear from you. All right? I'll talk to you soon.